George Flingos, Australia's number one ranked bowler, back again with George's tips on improving your bowling. Today, we're going to talk about the approach and how best and easiest to get from here to the foul line to let the ball go. First thing we need to do is figure out where we need to stand before we start the approach, and the best way to do that is to take four easy steps. Let's go to the foul line and work out where we need to stand. An easy way of doing it is just to put your heel on the big dot in the middle of the line and take four easy steps. One, two, three, four. Give yourself another foot distance just to allow for a little bit of slide. So for me, that ends up right here. So for me and for my steps, this is my starting point. You should do the same as well. Now that we've figured out how far away from the foul line we need to stand, let's have a look at the dots and where best to stand to put us in a position to throw a strike. Now for right-handers, I recommend that you put your left foot on the middle dot and your right foot by the second dot. For left-handers, let's reverse it around. I wouldn't be too concerned at this stage with the dots outside of that. The reason why they're there is to assist with sparing pins on either side of the lane. So at the moment, let's just focus on throwing strikes. So let's pick up our ball. Me being left-handed, of course. And I'm going to position myself with my right foot on the big dot and my left foot on there. Now, you see a lot of the time, especially on movies, where people hold the ball there in the middle. Okay, this is actually not a good position to be in. Because with bowling, we actually want to create a pendulum, which is going to assist us getting the ball down the lane. So if we create a pendulum which starts here, the ball can only swing one way, which is to the outside of our body. So the best way to start bowling is to actually start with the ball to one side. So because I'm left-handed, I'm going to start with the ball to this side. And the reason behind that is that if I start to this side and I push the ball away, as it swings, it creates a nice straight swinging pendulum for me to hit my target further down the lane. So that's where we need to be on our step one, right there. Now we know where to stand, let's have a look at the four steps to the foul line so we know how to let the ball go best. Let's break each step up into a frame and I'll explain to you at every stage where your ball should be. So for the first frame, we're going to start with the ball to one side and we're going to push the ball away when we take the step. So our first step is like this. See, as my foot moved, my left arm moved as well. So that's basically the step there. Step one. Step two, we've created that pendulum now. Let's let the ball relax and do all the work and let the ball swing by itself. So the second step is basically the ball drops. Ball should be by your waist by that step. The third step, the ball's reached the height of its backswing. It's up here. And now we're ready to let the ball go in our fourth step. Fourth step, come through and let the ball go. So that's it in principle. Let's go grab a ball and put that into practice. And there you have it. Four-step approach on how to get from your dots down to the foul line and let the ball go correctly. Remember, the most important aspect of that whole approach is the initial push away. If you can create a beautiful straight pendulum to the side of your body, which enables the ball to swing straight, your ability to hit a target out on the lane and to throw the ball straight is a lot higher. Thank you, and good luck out on the lanes.